Hi, I'm Nancy Douglas, and welcome to another episode of our ProMedica Physicians Podcast. This is a series on orthopedics this time, and we are so pleased to have with us two physical therapists from sports care, Amy Jackson and Brendan Smith. Welcome.
Thank you.
We're talking today about physical therapy. So I think the best place to start would be to tell us a little bit about your specialty field and how it fits into the whole healthcare picture.
We at sports care specialize in sports medicine and orthopedic rehabilitation. So that basically comes down to dealing with muscles, bone injuries, as they relate mostly to athletics, but we see a lot of general population things also. So people who've had total joint replacements, people with back problems, and then our group of athletes.
Amy, how long have you been in this profession, and can you tell us what does it take to be a physical therapist?
Sure. I began practicing physical therapy in May 2004, so going on, it'll be 8 years in May. Currently, most of the programs in physical therapy are DPT or doctorate physical therapy programs. There's physical therapists that have their bachelor's as well as their master's. And so right now, a lot of the physical therapy programs are different, but you basically do your undergraduate work kind of in a bachelor's of science area with a pre-physical therapy emphasis, and then continue on in a physical therapy professional program. At this point, currently it's between 6 and 7 years total in school, and then you afterwards take a national board exam and a state laws and rules exam as well.
So it's pretty extensive education for people that aren't familiar with what the background is.
And if you're interested in the sports medicine aspect, there's a lot of different aspects to physical therapy. But one of the choices that people make is to get a bachelor's degree in athletic training, which is dealing with kind of first responder injuries to injuries in the athletic situation, in addition to some rehabilitation. That gives you a good precursor to then go on to the physical therapy doctorate. So if you're interested in sports medicine, that would be one way. Other people can go into a pre-physical therapy program, and that's a bachelor's degree, and then go on.
Okay. So tell me, what kind of patients do you see?
Basically, we see a wide range of patients. At sports care, kind of what Brendan was saying, we see more patients with the orthopedic emphasis. So we see people that are pre- and post-surgery. We see people with chronic and acute type injuries, so injuries that maybe just happened, so somebody with an ankle sprain or somebody that bent over and tweaked their back or whatnot, or we'll see people who maybe have had knee pain or hip pain for a long time, elected to go ahead and maybe have a total joint replacement for that, and so then we see them after surgery to help them get back to their normal everyday things, walking, working, whatever those things that they're passionate may be.
Now, by the time they come to you, have they received therapy in the hospital after their surgery? Or how is that determined?
Typically with a post-operative patient, if they were in the hospital, they will have received some physical therapy, usually a few days for a total joint replacement. It's a pretty short stay in a hospital. So you'll have the surgery, usually the next day you're getting therapy, and they do that for a couple days, and then you go home and then on to outpatient therapy. Or in some cases, some people go to some transitional care units where they require a little bit more assistance.
And at those units, they can have physical therapy as well. So it's kind of a nice continuum. You can do some pre-op therapy, as Brendan said, in the hospital, home therapy, and then outpatient. So it's kind of a progression with what you're working on with that client or patient.
Sure, and I would imagine you can have a very successful surgery, but if you don't follow up with the therapy, then you're at a loss for recovery?
I would say that it's very important when you're post-operative to get the proper therapy to help you regain the muscle function, the coordination, and the things that you'll need to get back to your daily activities that you like to do, and including some of the basic things like brushing your teeth and bathing and things like that. If you try to ignore that step, you're going to basically get a whole host of other problems because the muscles aren't going to regain their strength. Your motion may be limited. So you're really going to end up long-term probably with more problems than you had if you had just gone and had some therapy.
Sure. Now, you brought a couple things with you today if you want to go through and explain what some of these tools are for us.
Okay. So when we do a physical therapy evaluation, we're looking at a number of different things, and some of these tools help us figure things out. So if we take an example of someone who's had a knee replacement, we're going to be particularly interested in their range of motion. So we use what's called a goniometer, and I have two examples here. We have this big one, and what we do is line the ends up with some bony prominences that help us be accurate, and then we measure the actual angle of the joint motion. And then we take that at the time of initial evaluation, and then periodically through the treatment cycle, and then certainly at the end as we're wrapping up. So that helps us track how we're doing. A couple of the other things, we look at strength, and we usually look at that a few different ways. One of them is we actually use our hands and manually test strength. We can also look at functional strength, for example, watching somebody go up and down stairs, how well they can control themselves doing that. And then sometimes we have some tools like this will measure your grip strength. So you just hang on to this and squeeze it, and it will tell you the amount of pounds of pressure that you're able to squeeze. And again, we recheck those things periodically through your treatment cycle to make sure that you're progressing.
Mm-hmm. What is this for?
This helps us check how reflexes are. So one of the things that we evaluate post-operatively and sometimes when we're evaluating a spine is how well the nerves are conducting information. So testing reflexes is one of those ways to tell that. And it's, you know, similar to what you would see a doctor do in an exam where they kind of tap the knee and the knee, the foot moves. So we look at the strength and the timing of how those reflexes happen.
So somebody that's had the total joint replacement, mm-hmm. what's their typical recovery time as far as how long they'll be seeing a mm-hmm. therapist?
That can kind of vary based on, you know, the patient, what type of surgery they had, how healthy or strong they were prior to the surgery, and then after, if they had any complications with the surgery itself or any health complications as well. A lot of times after a total joint surgery, though, the physician will write a script. Many times we see the patient a couple, 2 to 3 times a week for around 4 weeks initially. Some people don't need all of those 4 weeks and do, you know, are done before that. Some people need usually a little bit more than 4 weeks in general, but that's kind of the starting point that many of the physicians will recommend for physical therapy and kind of go from there. So, you know, anywhere from, you know, a month to a couple months out, especially after a total joint replacement, isn't uncommon before people reach, you know, their full potential or kind of on their way where they can do things on their own, more so at home versus informal physical therapy.
What happens after the evaluation?
Well, working with the patient, we establish goals, and we try to make those goals realistic. And we look at those goals and then what we find with our physical measurements, and we come up with a plan. That plan is then communicated with the doctor. The doctor will approve that plan, and then we start. Usually on the day of evaluation, we actually give some people some exercises to do at home to get them started, and we will add progress things as they can tolerate. Again, all designed to meet the goals that they have established.
If your physician has not recommended a particular place to go to for physical therapy, what should a person look for when they're making the selection and where to go?
We like to recommend places where the therapists look, in addition to the injury or the surgical site itself, to other areas of the body. For example, an athlete who has a ACL tear and has it reconstructed, probably before the tear, there may have been some weaknesses or something that led up to that. And a lot of times it's not right in the knee, it may be in the hip, there may be some dysfunction at the foot. So being able to look beyond that site really helps treat the whole person. When we're looking at long-term function, we always look at how people are able to do the activities that they like to do. So getting them back to those activities and then trying to prevent further issues down the road. So having that almost global approach to the body is really where we would recommend someone to be able to see somebody who can do that.
Another thing, kind of in addition to what Brendan had said as well, is to kind of look at what the patient's goals are and what they're trying to achieve. Some patients that have a lot of arthritis in other joints, you know, aside from the joint that was replaced, may want to pick a site that has the aquatic option or a pool that they can do exercises in. Many times we have patients that, you know, are doing really well after surgery, but once their wound and surgical site is healed, some of the things that we might do on land or in therapy may kind of irritate some of those other joints. So having the pool at a facility is helpful. So knowing, you know, that option is at the facility is a good thing to know too. So kind of knowing what each facility has to offer within it as well logistically is a good idea also.
And tell me a little bit more about the sports care facilities. Where are they located and
sure.
What the...
Our sports care site is located at 2865 North Reynolds Road. We're on the Wildwood campus, so we're basically connected to the new Orthopaedic and Spine Hospital in that building. And then our Sylvania site is on Haroon Road at Haroon and Holland, Sylvania. And that's kind of a smaller site that also offers sports care services.
One of the advantages of being at sports care, particularly at the Wildwood location, is that we share the physical space with the athletic club, so we are able to utilize all their equipment, the pool, basketball court, track, all the weight machines, so we have a very wide variety of activities that people can do. So if you have basic goals of just getting back to walking, we can handle those things, but if you have greater goals, getting back to water skiing, playing basketball, golf, things like that, we can address those issues very well there.
What's the best prevention, I guess you'd say, prevention of injuries, and then the quickest way to recover? Mm-hmm. Does it really depend on the overall physical health of the person, what kind of shape they're in?
I think that's an interesting question, because a lot of people, you know, obviously are wanting to know that, and with a lot of the higher level athletes that we do see and people that maybe aren't high level athletes, a lot of people kind of focus in on one area. You know, they say, I want to improve my flexibility, or I want to improve my strength, or I want to improve my balance. But I think, and you know, at sports care, I think we do a nice job of making sure we're integrating all of those things. So I think when you're training for a specific thing, to make sure that you're paying attention to all those areas of fitness and health, you know, making sure you're working on muscle strength and flexibility, because they do kind of go hand in hand in balance. And if you have all of those components, then you're usually a little better in preventing injury in general. So I think just kind of a very comprehensive approach is a good way in prevention.
I think especially with younger athletes, a variety of activities. We certainly see a lot of younger athletes that are focused on one sport, for example, soccer or swimming. And we've really kind of lost these multiple varsity letter athletes where, you know, someone will play baseball, they'll play basketball, they'll play football, and they're really focusing on one sport. I would recommend a variety of sports, and I think that helps your body adjust to different things. You don't get the physical or emotional burnout.
Amy, how does someone get to sports care? Do they have to be referred by a physician?
Most often and very traditionally, many patients are referred by a physician with a prescription for physical therapy. They don't necessarily have to have a prescription to come to us. By law, in Ohio, we do have direct access for physical therapy, so a patient can come without a prescription from the physician. Typically, though, at this point in time, many insurances in our area or in Ohio will only cover physical therapy services if the patient does have a prescription from the doctor. And so that's the main way that we see patients and clients right now. We do also have a nice option called prompt pay or direct pay, where patients can come in with or without a prescription and pay out of pocket if they don't have insurance or if they have a large deductible and would rather not use their insurance. So there's a few different ways to access us.
What's the best way to reach sports care?
Probably the best way to be to phone our office, and our phone number at Sports Care at Wildwood is 419-578-7530. And at our Sylvania site is 419-824-1323. And we can try to answer any questions we can about coming to see us or anything really about physical therapy in general.
Great.
Or you can visit www.promedicasportscare, that's all one word, .org.
Okay. ProMedicaSportsCare, all one word, .org. I'm Nancy Douglas. Thank you for joining us for another episode of ProMedica Physicians Podcast at ProMedica, where our mission is to improve your overall health and well-being.